Are you wondering what is mitochondrial DNA and do I need to take a mitochondrial DNA test? Today, I'm going to go over some of the basics of mitochondrial DNA and whether or not a test would be good for you. Howdy, welcome to Family History Fanatics, where we love helping you climb your family tree and have fun along the way. If you're new to genetic genealogy, then chances are you have questions. Well, check out the link in our description below to the 5 most common questions we are asked about DNA. You've probably heard about mitochondrial DNA and are wondering what it is and how it might be useful. Well, mitochondrial DNA is sometimes called the maternal DNA or the mother's DNA, and that is because it is passed on from mother to children. Let's go over the whiteboard and let's talk a little bit about DNA and what's different about mitochondrial DNA so you can understand how it might be useful in your genetic genealogy. When we think about DNA, mostly what we're thinking about is what is in the nucleus of our cells. And so there is going to be a pairs of chromosomes. So there's one pair, here's two pairs, here's three pairs, four pairs, and for humans there's 23 pairs. I'm not going to draw them all out. Now, besides the DNA that is in our nucleus of our cells, there happens to be some DNA in another part of our cell called the mitochondria. And this DNA is actually a little circle. So it's not a rod or a chromosome like we normally think of. It is actually a circular portion of DNA. So here's a couple of big differences that we have. So this DNA that's in our nucleus, it is 3 billion letters long. 3 billion, that's a lot. Whereas this mitochondrial DNA is only 16,000 letters long. So it is much smaller, much shorter amount of DNA than the rest of our DNA, than any single one of our chromosomes. Even the shortest chromosome, the chromosome number 22, is something like 40 million letters long. So this mitochondrial DNA is tiny, really, really tiny. Now, how or where did this DNA come from? Well, let me draw a picture of a cell. And this is going back to biology. And I said before that the DNA that we're talking about with chromosomes number 1 through 23 is in the nucleus right here. And I'm just going to draw a couple of lines there to represent that DNA that is in there. This other DNA, this mitochondrial DNA, is in some other parts of our cells called mitochondria. And each cell has hundreds and sometimes even more of these mitochondria. They're very important to the biological process of creating energy. Now, what's interesting is from our study of science, what has happened is about 1.5 billion years ago, we had, everything was just a single cell. There was different cells that, you know, did different things, and they were all just floating around, you know, doing their business. And in some of these cells, they were really good at making energy. And what happened is that another cell went and basically enveloped that one and brought it inside of itself. And so now what you had is you had a cell within a cell. And they developed and grew like that. And that is where our mitochondria came from. And so that's why this mitochondrial DNA actually looks very different from the rest of the DNA we have, is because it was from originally 2 completely different cells that joined together to give us what we have today. Now, this happened before plants developed. This happened before fungi developed. Like I said, this happened back when everything was single cellular. And so every multicellular, which means plants, animals, fungi, they have this structure, this mitochondrial structure, because it's all descended from these original cells that enveloped these other cells that happened to have this process that they were really good at. So that is the biology lesson that we have for today. How then does mitochondrial get passed on? Well, in the sex cells of humans, there are eggs and sperm. The mothers have the eggs and the fathers have the sperm. All that the fathers contribute to the child in the end, it really is just their nuclear material. They don't contribute all the rest of the part of the cell. And so this cell that we have here is combined with the mother's cell and a little bit of the father's DNA. And that's why mitochondrial DNA is passed down from mother to children, because every single one of these mitochondria came from the mother. None of them came from the father. Now, the second part of that question then is should you take a mitochondrial DNA test? The answer to that is it depends. Do you have a DNA question that could be answered? Recognizing that mitochondrial DNA is passed from mother to children, if the question is on some other part of your tree, then a mitochondrial DNA test is not going to help you out. Two other things complicate whether a mitochondrial DNA test is going to help you with your genealogy. One is that traditionally the females took on the male names, and so there's not a surname that you can really attach to any of these mitochondrial lines. You have to know each one of those individuals, you know, throughout that line. The second thing is that, again, mitochondrial is only 16,000 letters long, and not all of those letters are different. There's only a couple hundred of them that are going to be different for, you know, all the different people in the world. And that means that those changes happen over thousands of years. They don't happen rapidly at all. So even if you do have a mitochondrial DNA match, that person may be hundreds or thousands of years related to you before you have a common ancestor, which is beyond where most genealogical records are from. And so the advice that I normally give people is, if you have exhausted everything from autosomal DNA, and if you have exhausted all of your different genealogical research as far as paper genealogy records and different things like that, and if you have the money, then go ahead and get a mitochondrial DNA test. But recognize that it's probably not going to answer the question. That doesn't mean it will never answer the question, just that it probably will not answer the question. Mitochondrial DNA tests are primarily done at Family Tree DNA, and they cost a couple hundred dollars. So again, unless you have the money and unless you've exhausted your other resources, there's probably not a reason to get a mitochondrial DNA test. Now, I've had a mitochondrial DNA test, but it really was just for learning to be able to show different things on this channel. I have never used my mitochondrial DNA test for any kind of genealogy research, and I don't expect to. If you still have questions about DNA, then join us in our DNA live streams where we answer your questions. And consider joining FHF Extra, where we have even more DNA Q&A sessions as well as webinars. Now, if you would like to learn more about other types of DNA, I have this video up here. But if there's something else you want to learn, then why don't you try looking at this video down below? I'm losing my voice. Hopefully I can get through all of these.